We are doing the IT Grade 12 paper, the prac exam from November 2019, and we are busy with question 2.2 in this video. So just to recap, we are dealing with two tables. We're dealing with a players table, which has details of players, their names and so on, and their ID number, team name, skill level, and if they're a goalkeeper or not. And we're dealing with a table where there's details of the teams, who the coaches and the games that they've won and so on. And then they remind us that we are using those variables to access the ADO table for the teams, and that's the ADO table for the players. So let's go to question 2.2.1. So yeah, we've got the question. We've got an under 18A team includes some of the junior players that are exceptional. Junior players are players that were born after the year 2002. And just to note, the first two digits of an ID number indicate the year that you were born. So the first two digits. So if you were born in 2002, then your ID number will start with 02. If you were born in 2004, it would be 04. So that's something to be aware of for this question. So we want to write code that saves the surnames and names of the junior players who are members of the under 18A team to a new text file. So we've got some text file handling here as well. So there's the new text file. And take note, it's a new text file. We're not adding onto a text file. We're just creating a new one every single time we click on this button. Then we must determine the number of junior players and then have that displayed in a label. So we're going to create a text file, and then we're going to just update this label with how many names we added basically to the text file. Okay, so there's quite a bit that we need to do. Yeah, there's no details about doing some error checking for the text file, so we're going to double check. We don't need to do that actually. So let's go into the question. So I'm going to scroll down here to, I'm assuming it's on this button, junior players in the 18A team. And so here we go. So we, first of all, we know we're dealing with the text file. So straight away, I'm going to create my text file variable. Call it my file of type text file. Okay, so we've got a text file variable. Okay, so that's the first thing. And now we are going to have to assign files. So we're going to assign this text file variable to the name of the text file that they wanted me to call it. And they wanted me to call it junior_14a.txt. So I'm just going to copy that and say, hey, this is what the name of the text file must be. And then because we are writing a text file and we create a new one, we must rewrite it. We're not going to append it. We're assuming anytime we click on this button, it must reset it to, not reset it, but recreate it. So we're going to rewrite the file. So whatever was in it before must go away. And we are going to go through the players table because that's going to tell me the details of the player, their age, and so on. So we're going to, now the algorithm for going through a table, we go TBL players. Remember, we're using that ADR component. We start at the top. We start at the very beginning, dot first. And while we are not at the end of the table, TBL players dot end of file, while we are not there, begin end, we're going to be doing stuff here. But once we've done stuff with the with each record, we then will say TBL players dot next. So that's the three steps that we always do. Go to the first record while we're not at the end of the file, keep doing stuff. This is what we're going to do. So we can start off with the first record, do what we want, then go to the next one, then do the second one, go to the next one, and so on, and so on, and so on. So that's our algorithm that we always go through when dealing with the database table, if we're going through every field in it. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is we need to find out what year they were born. Okay, so if you remember correctly, there was an ID field. If I scroll up a little bit, and it's going to be annoying to see this, it's getting dizzy. So there's an ID number field, and we want to get the first two characters of the ID number field of this player table. So let's go do that. So we want to get that field as a year. So I'm going to actually make a year variable. I'm going to make it a year of type integer. And we are going to say, okay, this here variable is going to be whatever is in TBL players. And in square brackets, we're going to say the ID number field. Now, I don't want the whole ID number field. I just want the first two characters. So we're going to copy from this. Now, I'm copying it. I'm assuming that this is actually a string field. I can't remember if they specified that, but because there's a leading zero, that zero wouldn't stay there if it was a number field. So the only way they would keep the 03 or 02 there would be if TBL player's ID number was actually a text field. So I can confidently say, take it in as a text field. And we want to copy from the ID number the first two characters. So we want to start at position one and copy for two characters. Okay, so that's great. So we're going to do that. But I want to treat this as a number because I need to compare it as a numerical value. So I'm going to convert this string to an integer so that I can store it in the year variable, and then I can use it and do like numerical analysis, like is it greater than and stuff like that. So I can do that. So I'm doing that for each and every record. So the first record we get to extract the year. So we've done that part. So we've extracted the year. Now what I want to do, I want to check if they are born, if you remember correctly the question, born after the year 2002. So that means that would be 2003 or 2004. So we want the year to be a 3 or bigger. Okay, if that makes sense, it must be bigger than 3. So if the year is greater than equal to 3, then we have a unique player. But there was something else. What was it? It's only for this team. Remember, we only want the under 18 team. So we want to make sure that we only refer to that team because there might be younger players in the lower team. So only the under 18A team. So we must only, so there are two criteria. It's if the year is that, and if the team name that the player's in, TBL players. Now, what was that team name? Let's go have a look. Oop, there, scroll up. Boop, 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 boop. All the way up here. I've gone too far. Boom. There. Team name. So there's the team name field. So we're going to go back to our code. So if the team name field is equal to the under 18, I think it was under slash 18 space A, and that is a string. So if we want it to be the under 18A team, then we know that they are an exceptional player from that particular team. But remember, because we use an if statement and there's an and, we must put our brackets around our condition. So there we go. There we go. There we go. Okay, so what happens if we find an exceptional player? So this is what we do. End of it. So if we find an exceptional player, we want to add them to the text file. We've already opened the text file, so we want to write line to the text file. What do we want to write line? We want to write down, if you remember, they formatted all the way down again. Oh, I hate the scrolling. We want to write it with the surname and then the name, surname space name. So if you remember, there is a player surname field and there was a player name field. So we need to display those two fields in the text file. So I'm going to say, okay, TBL players, the player surname field we want to put in there, plus a space, plus the TBL players player name. So those are that's how we want it to be. Take the surname, put a space in between, and then put the name. And that's what we want to put into that text file. So we write line into it. That's great. And then we go to the next field. And then at the end of this loop, we would have done everything we need to do. So I'm going to say, okay, close that text file so that it's done. And there we go. That should be it. I know we haven't done the how many there are, but let's just test this part first to see if that works. So yeah, we can see the files. We can see there's no text file. We're going to run it. Let's keep that there so we can see. So we're running it. Boom. We're going to go to the Delphi code part. We're going to run this part. Okay, it went through. Oh, something happened here. What happened? Ah, there's a text file. Did it have the names? And there's the two names. And that looks like the two names that they mentioned in the example. So we know that that part is working. Okay, the second part was we had to display how many names or that we found, so we can have some sort of count variable. So let's have a count Dracula variable, our count, and we can initialize it because obviously when we start this, we have no values to refer to, so we make it count. And every time we find an exceptional player, not only do we write it to the text file, but we are going to increase our count. And then once everything is done and dusted, we can then say, okay, where do we want to display that? They said in LBL Q22, we want it to look like that. The number of players, junior players in the under 14A team is a 2. So we're going to write it like that. So LBL question 2.2.1 dot the caption of it is going to equal to number of junior players. So type it as in number of junior players in under slash 18A team. And then next to that, we're going to put the I count variable. But remember, the count variable is an integer, and this caption is a string. So we're going to convert it from what it is, an integer, to a string. So that can happen. Boom. Let's test it now. Run. What are the errors, Mr. Long? What are the errors? Okay. Too many brackets here, probably. Boom. So, no. Why have I got an extra bracket there? Thinking of it's a show message. That's why. Okay. So we come here. Boom. Display. Boom. Number of junior players in the team? 2. There we go. Well done. So we've done that question. For more videos in this video series on this exam paper, go to our YouTube channel. Please click on that subscribe button. Leave a comment. We'd love to hear from you. And remember, don't do it the long way. Do it the Mr. Long Way.